Goat is non-vegetarian. Bullock is non-vegetarian. Vegetarian. Goat is vegetarian. Cow is vegetarian. Bullock is vegetarian. And tiger will eat only vegetarian. Only vegetarian. Because this is the law of the God. God has created the food in the form of vegetarian animal for non-vegetarian animal. If tiger will eat goat, it is a non-violence because it is done by according to natural law, the law of the God. If human being will eat vegetarian, okay, it is according to the law of the God. It is 100% following law of the God. It is non-violence. But if 100% pure vegetarian human being will eat non-vegetarian, it is a violence. It is a violence because it is not according to God's rules and regulation. It is a Bhagavat. That means it is a totally anti-God rules and regulation. From which monkey the human being developed, now today also monkey is 100% vegetarian. It is the desire of the God, human beings should only vegetarian, not at all non-vegetarian. When you eat 1 kg of the meat, you are committing the mistake by which the people, those who are not getting meal to eat, they are without taking the food, they are sleeping in the night. And social crime, because for creation of the 1 kg meat, you have to feed 8 kg of the grain to the animals. If you are non-vegetarian, you are replacing the vegetable curry by the meat. All other factors are same. You want roti, you want rice, you want spices, you want onion, everything you are eating only, you are replacing the vegetable curry by this meat. What a difference? None of the vegetarian animal will eat meat, not at all, at any cost, not at all. Cow, you have not seen, the cow is eating meat, the buffalo is eating meat, bullock is eating meat, goat is eating meat, not at all. Elephant, a big giant animal, you keep the heap of the meat, you do not give the grass to eat, it will suicide itself, but will not touch the meat, will not. 100% following of the God's rules and regulation, 100%. And that is, that animals are really spiritual. And you people, are you spiritual? When the cow is dying, the cow is taken and fallen outside your village. And to eat the cow meat, the birds are coming. What is that? A big bird. What is the name? They are coming to eat the meat of dying that animal. And you first cut the neck of the hen, and then you meet the meat. Who are you? Those animals are eating dead body, and you are eating also? Who are you? Satyu, it is a violence. If you are eating meat, every animal is the son, children of the God. Every animal is the children of the God. God has not given permission you to kill his children, the God's children, in the form of hen and all other animal. It is against the God's rules and regulation. Satyu, that means there are specific gaps in the definitions of the violence and non-violence. Specific gaps. The insects are coming to attack the plant. Actually, they are not coming to attack the plant. Though God has given another rule, the stout, strong man has a right to kill the weakest. And when plant become weakest, then they will attack. Otherwise no. Insect are the food of predators. Insect are the food of predators. Predators means threat insect. This is the actual natural biological control. That is the biological control. That attempt has not given by the God to you that you kill the insect, not at all. This contact is not given by the God to you. To kill the insect, that contact is given to the friend insect, that is predators. If the friend insect will eat the harmful insect, that is non-violence. But if non-violence insect will eat friend insect, that is violence. According to rule of the God. Satyu, another truth is that without invitation card, insects are not attacking on your crop. The crop send invitation card and then they will come to attack. How we will discuss now? There is another rule of God. None of the living being, including vegetation and animal and human being also, none of the living being accept external body to enter its own body. Again, I would like to repeat, none of the plant body or human body or animal body accept the external bodies to enter its own body. कोई भी शरीर बाहर की वस्तु अपने शरीर में प्रवेश करना निषिद्ध मानता है, स्वीकार नहीं करता. What is happen? You are utilizing urea. When urea get moisture, the urea molecules are splitted and ammonia carbon dioxide is created. Roots cannot take ammonia as it is. Then some species of the microorganism, just like nitrosomonas, they convert ammonia into nitrate, and then nitrate are available to the plant body. The habits roots, habit crop roots, or genetically modified crop roots, have the mentality to eat more than requirement. They do not follow the rules of the God that astya aparigraha. They are not following at all. If the root of the hybrid crop or genetically modified crop want 10 gram of the nitrate, they will take double 20 gram of the nitrate. Among these 20 gram, 10 gram will be utilized by the roots, and rest of the 10 gram, which is not required at all, that 10 gram nitrates will be deposited in the vacant space between two cells of the body. There is another vacuole inside the cell. The nitrates are deposited in this vacuole also. That means intercellular vacuoles and intracellular vacuoles are fulfilled by the nitrates. Nitrate is a dangerous foreign body, very poisonous, very dangerous foreign body enter in the body of the roots. When you spray insecticide, within 7 seconds, all the residues of the insecticide are sucked by the roots and deposited in the packed body inside the cell. This is residues of the insecticide. When you utilize vermicompost is having very hazardous, poisonous heavy metals just like cadmium, arsenic, mercury, lead. And these heavy metals, which are the best poison, hazardous poisons, are again deposited in the fat, in the cells. Cadmium, arsenic, mercury, and lead. Very poisonous. Now, nitrate is foreign body. Residues of the insecticides also foreign body, and heavy metals are also foreign body, enter in the plant body. Then the leaves become very excited because of the entrance of these enemies. And itself, leaves cannot evacuate these foreign bodies. So they send messages in the air to invite the insect, please come on, suck and remove these foreign bodies. The messages are having variable wavelengths, and the messages are spread out in the air to call the insect. Oh, jacid, please come on. Oh, aphid, you also come. Oh, whitefly, you also come. These Pakistani militants are entering our border, Kashmir. So, you come and please evacuate. And then after the invitation card, the insects are coming, suck the juice, that means they are remove foreign bodies, and then plant be cool and calm. I know agriculture scientists and all scientific era will not accept my theory that the plant sent the invitation card. They will not accept, I know. Because they do not know what is the natural science. They learn in the university only foreign, unnatural science, which is called agriculture science. Totally nonsense, totally fraud. I will give an example. They have to give the answer. You go to the forest, the huge tree with uncountable fruits, export quality. The fruits, export quality, no damage at all. Why there is no insect attack in the forest? On the roadside, there are so many plants and trees, no attack at all, free of attack. Why? Why insects are not attacking there? 40 lakh farmers are practicing herbicide farming. Why there is no insect attack on our crop? Pomegranate is totally destroyed by bacterial blight. Totally destroyed in India. No single damage of bacterial blight in natural pomegranate. Why? Why there is no insect attack? Mealybug has destroyed the cotton belt. There is no mealybug attack on zero-bait natural farming cotton. Why? They have to give the answer. Sathyo, why the forest trees are saved, why there is no insect attack? Why there is no insect attack in urban natural farming? Because we are not utilizing urea. So no problem, no question is arise, because when you not applying urea, nitrate all not deposited in the plant body, and nutrition are not sent. We are not spraying hazardous chemical insecticide, so no residues at all and no inhibition. We are not utilizing vermicompost, no cadmium arsenic are depositing in body and no inhibition. That's why there is no inhibition. Without inhibition, the insect will not come, and they are not coming on our plant. They are not coming on our crops. You stop the chemical farming. You stop organic farming, more dangerous organic farming. There will be no attack. God has given a beautiful gift, not only human being, to entire living being. That is the resistance power. Two sons of same mother and father. One family. One is continuously suffering by diseases. And one is strong. No any disease. Very strong. Why? Father is same. Mother is same. Food is same. Mother love is same. Everything is same. Why this suffering continuous by the diseases? Why he is not suffering by the diseases? Because who suffer by the disease, there is no resistance power in the brain body, and who do not suffer, they have the resistance power in the plant, in the body. That means medicine is not a remedy. Understood? Medicine is not a remedy at all. These agriculturalists are misguiding the nation and entire world that medicine is the remedy. Not at all. To create the resistance power is the real remedy. Is the real remedy. This is zero budget natural farming power, and this is the boundary. And his brother, real brother, is practicing chemical farming. Nearest, only 1 feet boundary, and this chemical. This is pomegranate. And he also has pomegranate. And his pomegranate nearer, 1 feet distance between two plants, chemical and natural. His pomegranate is totally destroyed by the bacterial blight, and there is no bacterial blight in zero budget natural farming. Same, 2 feet distance in between two plants. Why? Why? Because they are, insects are coming, diseases are coming. But by means of the resistance power, they are not come damaging our crop, and they are damaging neighbor crop. Medicine is not a remedy, Sathiyo. To create the resistance power is the remedy, and agriculture has destroyed the resistance power by means of the chemical fertilizer and insecticide. And then they are again suggesting to utilize all these things. This is, I think that this is not a natural, unnatural science it is. Medical science claim that harmful bacteria enter in the human body first, and when the harmful bacteria are entering in the human body, they create a disease. This is the theory of medical science. This is also a wrong theory. I will give an example given in the first day also. TB hospital, hundreds of the TB patients are residing in the TB hospital. When they take respiration, close of the tuberculosis bacteria are thrown in the atmosphere regularly. In each moment, they are throwing the lakhs of the bacteria of tuberculosis in the atmosphere. In that hospital, nurses are giving services, doctors are giving services, relatives are sitting there. When they take the respiration, this maximum bacteria, that means lakhs of the bacteria entering in the body of those doctors, nurses. But every doctor and nurses are not suffering by TB. Why? Why? Because there is a resistance power in the body, so they are not suffering by the tuberculosis. That is the real natural science, that the medicine is not a remedy. To create the resistance power, here is the real remedy. Another system God has created, that is the biological control. Harmful insects are controlled by the friend insect, that is predators. Friend insects are small quantity, but they kill thousands of the harmful insect.
Small quantity?
The predators, that means friend insects are small quantity, but they kill more quantity of the harmful insect. Mealybug is the main insect in vegetables, cotton, and orchard also. Mealybug damaged the crop in large scale. But in zero budget natural farming, to eat the mealybug insect, the predators are coming, just like Cryptolinus montagyri, Scimnus coxiura, just like all the predators are coming, and they kill the mealybug. You will see, in zero budget natural farming, there is no mealybug there, there is no mealybug over there. Sathiyo, that means we have to utilize this natural system to give the enhancement to the predators, friend insect, and so that those friend insect will kill the harmful insect, and biological control will be done naturally, and no effort to kill the insect by human being, not necessary at all. There are specific host plants on which the friend insects are residing. we have to arrange these plants, host plant, as an intercrop in our main crop to decide the friend insect. Which are those which are those plants on which the friend insects are residing, and they control the harmful insect, write down the list of the intercrops, beneficial intercrops, which control the harmful insect. Cowpea, moth bean, pigeon pea, marigold, mace, bajra, that means millet, whole wheat based ill, what is called? Tulasi. Tulasi, coriander, dhania coriander, mustard, carrot, radish, drumstick, cowpea, moth bean, horse gram. I have not written horse gram?
No.
Cowpea, moth bean, pigeon pea, marigold, mace, horse gram, bajra, drumstick, tulasi, coriander, mustard, carrot, radish, and soap. What is called soap? Body shape?
Soap.
Soap. We have to manage all these intercrops in the main crop. We will discuss when we will take the technology about the crop pattern. In Tamil?
Dhania.
Dhania? Huh? Dhania? Pauda kya hai? Pattamali. Pattamali. Kothimbir. Kothimbir? It is a Marathi word? Huh? Is a big okay. And yesterday's orchard model we have established, right? We have taken drumstick also, cowpea also, maize also, moth bean also. Even we are arranging the marigold also and the tulasi also. Write down. The God has created, God has given the miracle gift to living being, that is resistance power. These resistance power are created in the local seeds. This resistance power is created in the local seeds. Naturally, by the nature, the local variety has the capacity. Local variety has the capacity to adjust and fight with the natural calamities and climate change, with the natural calamities and climate change, by means of the internal mutation process, by means of the internal mutation process, this resistance power is transferred to next generation by the local varieties. If the local varieties are developed in zero budget natural farming or natural way of farming, but if you are taking the local varieties in chemical farming, if you are taking growing local varieties in chemical farming, then the resistance power is reduced naturally, because the residues of the nitrates and insecticides change the gene's location on the DNA. As a result, characters are changed and resistance power is reduced. Everybody has the possibility to suffer by cancer-like diseases. There is an oncogene in the DNA which is responsible for cancer. If this oncogene slips forever, that means it becomes recessive, you will not suffer by cancer at all. But when this oncogene become dominant, break the slip and become dominant, then definitely you will suffer by the cancer. And this dominancy is given by the residues of the insecticide, nitrates and the heavy metals. Even in crop also it is happened.